right, good evening and welcome from Pioneer High School, where your Lady Dragons are on the road tonight to take on the Lady Panthers from Pioneer. I'm Steve Stricker alongside Alex Stearns on the camera. Going to have a little help tonight from my youngest, McKenna. She's going to give us a little bit of color commentator. Say hi, McKenna. Say hi, McKenna.
Hi.
Got to say it into the mic. If you're going to do it, you got to talk. All right, so we thank you for joining us tonight on this broadcast of Argos Voice Sports on RTC4.com and Channel 4 in Rochester. And we'd like to thank all of our sponsors, RTC Fiber Communications, The Zone Sports Complex in Northern Indiana, First Federal Savings Bank, H&H Contracting, Hereford Home Inspections, Argos Do It Best, In Stitches and Signs, Mr. Trophy, CNS Outdoor Power Equipment, CNS Automotive, Halderman Farm Management and Real Estate, Kelly Hoffman Agent, Oliver Ford, State Farm Insurance, and Shepherd's Chevrolet Buick. So the Class A number 2 Argos Lady Dragons come into tonight's game at 8-0 on the season, and they'll be taking on the Pioneer Lady Panthers, who are 2-5 on the year. Lady Dragons are coached, of course, by Gary Teal, who is 66-34 in his fifth season with the Dragons. And he's 224 and 144 in 17 seasons overall. Pioneers led by Jeff Brook, who is 2-5 in his first year with the Lady Panthers. Last game out, the Lady Dragons won at Elkhart Christian, 62-17. And Pioneer defeated Caston, 45-34 in the runner-up game or consolation game of the Cass County Invitational. We're going to get the national anthem and starting lineups and get set to go here from Pioneer High School. Wonderful rendition of the national anthem sung by Lady Panther player number 32, Emily Brook, a sophomore here at Pioneer High School.
Number 30, Emily Calhoun.
Starters for the Lady Dragons. First up, number 10, Courtney Dunlap, a 5'9 senior. Number 22, Kennedy Binkley, a 5'7 senior. Number 24, Macy Stricker, a 5'7 junior. Number 30, Emily Calhoun, a 5'7 senior. And senior 6 foot, number 50, Anna Barlow.
Number 24, Anna Parsley. Number 40, Madison Kaufman. Number 11, Tia Freshhauer. Number 15, Madeline Parsley. And number 2, Haley McWhorter.
All right, they did them backwards. Normally I like to go down the top. So number 2, a senior, 5'7", Haley McWhorter. Number 11, the former Lady Dragon, T. Tia Freshour, a 5-foot sophomore. Number 15, a sophomore, 5'10 guard, Madeline Parsley. Number 24, Anna Parsley, a 5'6 freshman. And number 40, Madison Kaufman, who is a 5'10 sophomore forward for the Lady Panthers. Anna Barlow is going to tip against McWhorter, and it goes to Dunlap for the first possession of the game. Stricker has it at the top, passes over to the right to Calhoun, who gets it down to Dunlap. Back to Calhoun, high post to Binkley, over to the wing, and a long three-pointer is no good for Dunlap, and rebound by the Lady Panthers. They're going to push ahead. Freshour has it. Binkley's on Freshour. Number 15, Parsley, is guarded by Stricker. She passes over to Kaufman. Over to Freshour with Binkley on her. Parsley gets it back to Freshour. They're setting up a play here. Freshour takes it. Nice pass inside, but the shot is missed. Rebound. And the third shot, and that's going to be a turnover. Madison Kaufman gets called for the travel. So, minute two gone here in the first quarter. No score on the board between the Lady Dragons and Lady Panthers. Calhoun, and she tries to get it inside, and a good job by McWhorter to tip it out of bounds. Dunlap's going to trigger the ball on the baseline for the Lady Dragons. Dunlap gets it into Barlow. Barlow finds Stricker for a three. That's off the mark. Good rebound by Calhoun. She throws it up and gets nothing, and the rebound to McWhorter. She's going to work on Dunlap. She gets inside, and there's a tip and a steal by Stricker. She's got Calhoun, and she goes one-on-one and misses, but Barlow gets the rebound, and there's going to be a foul on Pioneer, number 15.
Madeline Parsley.
Madeline Parsley, and that's going to put Anna Barlow at the line, shoot two. First free throw is good for Barlow, first points of the game. 6:23 left to go here in the first period. Another free throw coming up here for Anna. And it's off the mark, and the rebound goes to Parsley for Pioneer. There is a long shot rebounded by Kaufman and puts it in for the 2-1 Pioneer lead. And Binkley from 18 foot is good. Gives the Lady Dragons a 3-2 lead. And a little full court pressure here by Argos. Binkley gets the steal, and she looked for Calhoun, but the pass was offline, and it's going to go out of bounds to the Lady Panthers. Full court pressure here. There's a trap between Binkley and that's going to be off of Pioneer and going to be Lady Dragon's ball. Calhoun looks for Barlow, almost stolen by Lady Panthers. Calhoun's going to take a three, and it's going to be long, rebounded by Parsley. Binkley almost gets the steal. Freshour comes up with it, pulls up for 15-footer, and it's good. Gives the Panthers the 4-3 lead with 5 minutes left here in the first. And nice pass in from Binkley to Barlow. And there's going to be a foul. Looks like another foul on Parsley.
Fouls on Pioneer number two, Haley McWhorter.
They got McWhorter on that one. So her first, team second. Barlow's got two shots here from the free throw line. First one is good. That ties the game at 4-4 with 4:55 left to go. Second free throw here for Anna Barlow. And she misses, 2-for-4 here. And Binkley gets the rebound, gets it in to Dunlap, who is not able to put it in. Nice fake, like she was passing back out, and goes up and puts it in for two. First points of the game for Courtney Dunlap. And they're going to call a foul on... No, the Pioneer player went out of bounds. So turnover for the Lady Panthers. Stricker can't hit the three. And Dunlap gets the rebound, and she's going to be fouled. Looks like Parsley maybe with the foul.
Fouls on Pioneer number 40, Madison Kaufman. Her first, team number three.
So Dunlap is going to go to the line. Well, they got number 10, Johnson. Dunlap puts the free throw in. No, number 40, as I say, Johnson. So they got Kaufman with the foul. That is her first foul. Oh, this scoreboard can't read the four. Second free throw is good for Dunlap. Makes it an 8-4 lead with 4:27 left in the first. Pressure by the Lady Dragons. And it's deflected out of bounds off of Courtney Dunlap, so it'll stay Lady Panthers ball. Fresh air has it up top. 2-3 zone for the Lady Dragons. And a pass right to Calhoun. Another turnover, and Calhoun can't finish the layup. And Barlow, it's going to be called on the floor. And it's going to be a...
Fouls on Pioneer, number 11.
They're going to get Freshour on the foul. That's her first, team's fourth.
Number 32, Emily Brooke.
Emily Brooke is going to check into the game for Pioneer. And there's a turnover. They're going to call a double dribble on Dunlap. So turnover for the Lady Dragons with 4:01 left in the first. And there's the foul on Stricker. It's going to be the first foul on Argos.
Number 24, Macy Stricker, her first. Team number one.
Fresh hour inbounds it. There's a three-point attempt, and it's way off. And it's going to be out of bounds off of Macy Stricker. Fresh hour inbounds again. And that ball is going to go off of Pioneer, out of bounds. And it's going to be Argos ball. 3:46 left to go, 8-4. McKenna, you're not saying a whole lot here. Shaking your head, nobody can hear it. Three-pointer, top of the key, good for Dunlap. 11-4 now. And there's a steal, Dunlap gets it, and that's gonna be a foul on Freshour. And that's gonna be the second foul on Tia.
Pioneer number 11, Tia Freshour. First second.
And we got a sub coming in the game, number 23, Cassidy Morris. She's going to replace Madison Kaufman. And number 25 is going to replace Tia Freshour, and that's McKenna Landis for the Lady Pioneers. And a long shot there by Calhoun is rebounded by Stricker over to Calhoun for another three attempt, and it's just off the mark. And Stricker gets a hold of another one, and she throws it right to Landis, who crosses over. Beautiful little crossover reverse layup there by Landis. A nice athletic move there by the sophomore. Dunlap's off the mark and rebounded by Emily Brook for the Panthers. And there's a good block out by Stricker, and it's going to be an over the back on Parsley. I believe that's her second.
Umpire number 15, Madeline Parsley. That's her second, team number six.
Sixth team foul on Pioneer here with 2:35 left to go in the first. Barlow's going to come out and Kuntz will go in. And the Lady Dragons are going to be in the bonus here on the next Pioneer foul. Stricker for three. There we go. Drills it from the right side. That makes it 14-6 with 2 minutes. And there's a steal. Stricker can't put it in. And there's a turnover for Pioneer. So Emily Calhoun's going to go out. And Bailey Nifong is going to come in for her. With 2:10 left to go, it's 14-6. Stricker gets it to Dunlap. Dunlap over to Nifong. Back over to Stricker for another three. And it's good. Two in a row there for Macy Stricker. Makes it a 17-6 game, and Coach Brook wants a timeout for the Lady Panthers. So with a minute 56 left to go in the game, it's a 17-6 Argos lead. And we'd like to thank RTC Fiber Communications. RTC4.com is your source for all Argos Dragons sports action. Scott Sager, Alex Stearns, Abby Malco, all the gang there with RTC. Thank them for all their support and help to bring Argos Sports Dragons, or Argos Dragon Sports, to the internet. So, McKenna, you got any thoughts on the first quarter of action? All right, she's silent. I'm not used to having a partner that doesn't talk. With Andy normally on the other side of the headset for me. So McKenna's the silent partner here this evening. She likes wearing the headset apparently, but not speaking into it. It's going to be Lady Panther ball here with a minute 56 left to go and down 17-6. Still not quite over that cough that I've had for about 2 weeks now. But definitely a lot better than I was at the Morgan game. Good pressure there by Binkley. And almost turned over by the Lady Panthers. There's a trap in the corner with Binkley. And there looked like a nice little turnaround move by McCorder, but he said she moved her foot and gets called for the travel and a turnover for Pioneer. See what the Dragons can do here with a minute and a half left to go in the first. Stricker tries another three, and it's off the mark. Deflected and a steal. Stricker gets it down the floor. Can't get a good shot at a layup. There's a foul. Looks like maybe 25. Landis. Yep, they're going to get Landis, and I think that is her first. It's going to put Dunlap at the line, shooting 1-1. With 54 seconds left to go in the first, the Lady Dragons are in the bonus. So Dunlap, 1-1, first shot is good. with 18-6 now. Dunlap has another free throw coming up here for the Lady Dragons. Second free throw is good for Courtney. Full court pressure here for Argos. And nobody home. Tried to get it ahead to Parsley, but she wasn't looking for the ball, and it goes out of bounds. Another turnover for the Lady Panthers. Lady Dragons are going to look and see if they can get the last shot of the quarter. Nifong throws it away. McCorder comes up with the steal for the Lady Panthers. And Binkley returns the favor, takes it right back. Dunlap has it out top, 10 seconds to go. Dunlap drives the lane, can't put it in. And that's going to do it for the first quarter. 19-6 is your score. Argos with the lead. We're going to take a break here and come back with second quarter action here in just a minute. We'd like to thank First Federal Savings Bank in Rochester, www.firstfederalbanking.com. They're located at 310 East 9th Street. You can call them at 574-223-2128. Or you can visit them on the web at firstfederalbanking.com. They also have locations in Plymouth, Bremen, Elkhart, and Mishawaka for all your banking needs. First Federal Savings Bank of Rochester. So after one quarter of action, the Lady Dragons are up 19-6. Lady Pioneer Panthers have definitely improved a ton over the last couple seasons when we've seen them. They've got a good young squad, solid players, and it's good to see Tia Freshour out there. She's doing well here after the transfer. And got the start for the Lady Panthers. So she is back out on the floor with the Pioneer and drives to the bucket. And she gets the draws the foul. Binkley is going to be called for her first, I believe. And that's going to put Freshour at the line. Shooting two.
At the line.
And Freshour puts the first one in. Second free throw is good. So two free throws there by Freshour makes it 19-8. Dunlap gets it to Kuntz. And it's going to be a jump ball. It's going to stay Lady Dragons ball on the alternating possession. Dunlap gets it into Stricker. Stricker gets it over to Kuntz. Over to Nifong at the top of the key. Back over to Dunlap. Dunlap looks baseline. Nice pass to Kuntz. And unfortunately, it's not going to go in for Kuntz. But it's going to be tipped out by the Lady Panthers, and it's going to be Argos ball. Dunlap gets it over to Nifong. Nifong up to Stricker. Stricker gets a nice pass into Kuntz. Kuntz can't get anything going. Passes out to Dunlap. Dunlap from 10. She's off the mark and rebound by McWhorter. Freshour pushes the ball up fast. McWhorter leaves her. And there's a turnover by Stricker. Gets the steal and misses the layup. But Binkley's there to clean up her miss and puts it in for two. Another foul.
Number 24,
on Stricker. That's her second.
Macy Stricker, her second. Team number three.
So with 6:54 left to go in the second, and Coach Teal is going to go to the bench. Stricker's got to be smart here. Can't pick up the third foul. And the shot's off, but it's rebounded by Parsley. And right now the Panthers are beating the Lady Dragons to the ball. And number 25, McKenna Landis, is a tough little player inside there for the Lady Panthers. She's got two rebounds right there. Now she's going to go to the line, shooting two on the foul by Kuntz. First free throw is off the back iron. We got two subs, Barlow and Morgan Dunlap. They're going to come in for Stricker and Rachel Kuntz. Coach Teal's over there trying to figure out how to get Stricker to quit committing. Second foul in the second quarter. Dunlap brings it up, pulls up and gets it over to Morgan. Morgan gets a nice drive in the bucket but can't finish. And it's going to go off of Barlow out of bounds to Pioneer. 13-point lead for the Lady Dragons, but I don't think it's probably what they were expecting here with 6:20 left to go in the first half. Lady Panthers from Pioneer are giving them a lot more of a challenge than we've seen in the past. Nice drive all the way to the bucket by Landis. Can't put it in, and Dunlap gets a nice pass into Barlow. Can't convert, but she gets fouled. And it looks like they're going to call Parsley on that one. 24 is a popular number here tonight for the refs to call for fouls, right, McKenna? So that is the first on Parsley. Free throw goes in. Got a sub coming in. Emily Brooke is going to go out. Madison Kaufman comes back in for the Lady Panthers. Second free throw for Barlow is good. Makes it 23-8 with 6:03 left to go in the first half. Oh, a nice steal there by Morgan Dunlap. Gets a pass. Nice look over to Nifong, but unable to do anything with it and commits the traveling turnover. And there's a turnover, but Lady Dragons are out of bounds. So it's going to stay with Pioneer. Fresh Hour brings it across, gets it over to Landis. Landis looks to drive. She gets all the way to the bucket, unable to finish. And the rebound is good by Kaufman, and she puts the bucket in and gets the foul on Barlow. And that's going to be the fifth team foul, and I believe the second, first on Anna Barlow. And Madison Kaufman is going to the line to make the three-point play. And the free throw is off the mark, almost rebounded by Pioneer. And the ball, Dunlap tries to get it to Binkley, and goes out. Calhoun's going to come in for Nifong. There's a turnover for Pioneer. Dunlap gets it to Calhoun. Calhoun tries to find Morgan Dunlap, and it's going to be knocked out of bounds by the Lady Panthers. Courtney's going to trigger in. Calhoun for three. She's short. Rebound. Dunlap, and it's going to be poked out of bounds by Kaufman. Not necessarily the game that we expected from the Lady Dragons. They seem to be a little bit off on their game. And looks like they're going to call Kaufman, maybe. Yep, that's going to be Kaufman, and that's her second. It's going to put Anna Barlow at the line shooting 1-1. Got 5:12 left to go here in the first half, 23-10. And Anna gets the bounce, makes it 24-10. She's got another free throw coming up. Second free throw is good from Barlow. That's good to see. Two free throws there for Anna. Makes it 25-10. And deflected out of bounds by Calhoun off the pass from Parsley. Freshhour gets it into Parsley. Landis, my bad. Landis gets it to Parsley. And turnover. Pioneer. Morgan Dunlap can't handle it. Gets it over to Calhoun. Back to Courtney Dunlap. Courtney Dunlap gets it over to Emily Calhoun. Calhoun, nice little drop into Binkley. Nothing doing. Binkley gets it back out to Calhoun. Dunlap on the top with Freshhour guarding her. Morgan Dunlap drives it all the way to the bucket. She can't commit, convert, rebound to Courtney Dunlap, and the tie-up between Barlow and McWhorter, and that's going to be Lady Panthers' ball.
In the lineup for the Panthers, number 23, Cassidy Morris.
Cassidy Morris comes back in for the Panthers. She's going to replace Anna Parsley. Freshhour brings it across the timeline. Freshhour gets it to Landis. Landis is looking to drive on Morgan Dunlap. McWhorter has Courtney Dunlap on her. She's looking to drive. Nothing doing. Landis gets it back. Gets it over to Freshhour. Binkley's on her. McWhorter gets it knocked away. There's a nice strong move on the inside by Kaufman. Can't convert, though. And the rebound goes to Morgan Dunlap. Courtney brings it across the timeline. And there's a foul, and that's going to be the third, I believe, on Freshhour. No, they got 40. Kaufman, I think that's her third. It's her third, team 10, so that's going to put Dunlap at the line shooting the two-shot bonus. So with 3:27 left to go in the first half, 25-10, and Dunlap is shooting the two-shot bonus. First one is off the front iron. Courtney's a little off here this evening. Not her normal self here so far in the first half of action as far as her shooting goes. Second shot is good for Dunlap, 26-10. Freshhour gets it across to Landis. Landis looking to drive again. Gets it up to McWhorter. McWhorter, a nice little drop down pass to Brooke, but she can't handle it. And unforced error from Morgan Dunlap just passes it behind Courtney. So it's been a little bit of a turnover on both sides. They've had a high amount of turnovers here in the first half. Freshhour looking for a lane, can't find anything. Gets it over to Landis. Landis gets it to Brooke, back to Landis with Emily Calhoun on her. Freshhour, Calhoun picks her up, and Calhoun goes to the floor, and a jump ball call, and it's gonna go to the Lady Dragons. Emily Calhoun brings it across the timeline for the Lady Dragons. B Dinkley gets it inside. Dunlap, nice little turnaround jumper. Good post move for Courtney. Puts it in, makes it 28-10 with 2.5 minutes left to go in the first half. Landis again tries to drive, and Barlow's there to clean it up. Morgan Dunlap sees Calhoun. And Calhoun can't handle it cleanly and gets called for with a turnover on the travel. Landis has it on the left wing. Has Morgan Dunlap on her. Gets it over Freshour with Binkley on her. Landis for two, long two. Dunlap tracks down that rebound. Dunlap, nice pass up to Binkley. Puts it in for two. And we got a timeout on the floor with a minute 42 left to go in the first half. Argos has opened up a 30-10 lead over the Lady Panthers. And we'd like to thank the Zone Sports Complex in Northern Indiana. McKenna, you've spent some time up there at the Zone. What do you think of it? Okay, she's still not wanting to talk. She's shaking her head like I'm supposed to read her mind. The Zone Sports Complex in Northern Indiana is located at 2923 Van Vactor Drive in Plymouth. You can visit them on the web at www.thezonesportscomplex.org. Owners Rick and Barb Miller and Ted Hayden, operator Doug Griffiths, Dwayne Morton, former Mr. Basketball from Kentucky, as well as a NBA player for the Golden State Warriors, and of course Andy Stone, who is the director of soccer for the Zone. So we're back in action here with a minute and a half left in the first half. Lady Panthers have the ball. Turnover for Pioneer. And Dunlap tries to get it to Calhoun. A nice hustle play there by McWhorter and tips it out of bounds. Dunlap is going to trigger to Barlow, back up to Binkley. Dunlap takes a three, and it's good on the right baseline. So just like that, and Dunlap makes it 33-10 with a minute left to go here in the first half. And Calhoun steals the pass from Freshour. And Dunlap a little short, but Binkley gets the rebound. Back up top to Dunlap. Dunlap, oh, she saw Binkley in there and unable to get it to her, but she gets the ball back and puts it in for two. Forty seconds left to go in the first half. There's a steal by Morgan Dunlap. She's going to go coast to coast and puts it in for two.
Buckeye by number 34, Morgan Dunlap.
22 seconds left to go. And there's another turnover. Courtney Dunlap, she gets it to Calhoun. And Calhoun cannot finish the layup. And a good rebound there by McWhorter. 7 seconds. Freshour drives it to the lane and puts it in for two. And that's going to do it here for the first half. It's 37-12. Lady Dragons with the lead. We're going to take a break. We're going to get some halftime stats and come back here from Pioneer High School for some second half action here after this. All right, welcome back here to Pioneer High School, where the halftime score is the Argos Lady Dragons 37 and the Pioneer Lady Panthers 12. First half statistics for Pioneer. They are led in scoring by Tia Freshour with 6, Madison Kaufman with 4, and McKenna Landis has 2. The Lady Dragons are led in scoring by Courtney Dunlap with 17. Kennedy Binkley, Macy Stricker, and Anna Barlow all have 6 for the Lady Dragons. The biggest tale of the first half for both squads is the turnovers. Pioneer with 15 unofficially, and the Lady Dragons only with 7. So if Pioneer looks to get back into this one, they're going to have to do a better job of protecting the ball here in the second half. Foul-wise, Tia Freshour and Madeline Parsley have 2. Madison Kaufman has 3 for Pioneer. And Macy Stricker with her normal 2 fouls in the first half. Everybody else is 1 or 0. So not too much trouble here for either squad except for Madison Kaufman, who has 3 for the Lady Panthers. Would like to thank In the Stitches and Signs. Matt and Bobby Zahm are the owners, and they are located at 11189 State Road 10 in Argos. You can call them at 574-892-5956. They do embroidery, screen printing, signs, banners, vehicle lettering, magnets, decals, promotional materials, T-shirts, you name it, anything with printing on it or any kind of special embroidery, and they can do it. You can also visit them on the web at www.institches.com, institchz.com. Matt and Bobby Zahm at 574-892-5956, In Stitches and Signs. Rob Herford, owner of H&H Contracting and Herford Home Inspections. You can call Rob at 574-498-6013. He does concrete work, guttering, roofing, general contracting, as well as home inspections. If you're looking to buy a new home and need it inspected to make sure what you're getting yourself into, give Rob a call. And he will give you a full inspection to help you determine any issues that you may have with the property. Can also give you a written report on site. Herford Home Inspection strives to help you make the most informed decision on the purchase of your new property. Herford Home Inspection and H&H Contracting owner Rob Herford. You can call him at 574-498-6013. Well, we're getting ready for second half action here from Pioneer with a halftime score of 37-12. And it's going to be the Lady Panthers ball out of the break, I do believe. And they will have it here on the near sideline. I want to thank my silent partner here this evening in the broadcast, McKenna Stricker. She's very quietly sitting here with a headset on. Looks good, though. I'll even turn her mic up in case she has some words to say. Freshour has it. Gets it over to Parsley. And Parsley loses it out of bounds. Looks like Emily Calhoun knocked it out. Starters back on the floor for both squads. And a big screen that time by Kaufman. And a reverse layup, and Kaufman gets the rebound off of the miss by McWhorter. And she's going to get fouled by Courtney Dunlap.
Fouls on Argos number 10, Courtney Dunlap. Her first. Team number 1 at the line.
First foul of the second half, and Kaufman has 2 shots at the line. And the first one's off the front iron. Second shot is good for Madison Kaufman, her 5th point of the game. Makes it 37-13 with 7.5 left here in the third period. Nice backdoor screen. Stricker puts it in. Good pass from Dunlap.
Back to my number 24, Macy Stricker.
A And nice pass in to Fresh Hour to Kaufman. Can't get anything there. Back out. McWhorter has it. Tipped by Calhoun, and it's going to go out of bounds, and it's going to stay Pioneers ball. Emily Brooke has started the second half in place of Madeline Parsley for Pioneer. Emily was the one who did a very fine job singing the national anthem here this evening. And the pass by Freshour hits the bottom of the glass and is picked off by Kennedy Binkley. First turnover of the half. Calhoun gets it in, and Dunlap posts up on Freshour and puts it in for two. 6:20 left to go in the third. It's a 41-13 ball game. A nice looking shot there by Parsley. Unable to finish though. The pass ahead to Binkley is tied up by Kaufman, but it will remain Lady Dragons basketball. Dunlap triggers it in, nice pass, and nice little jumper there by Anna Barlow, puts it in for two. Freshour gets it over to McWhorter, back up to Freshour at the top of the key. Freshour calls Parsley over, back over to McWhorter. Freshour, Parsley. Looks into Kaufman, nothing there. Gets it back up top to McWhorter. She's going to drive the lane, and it's blocked by Barlow. Stricker has it coming down the floor. Stricker gets it over to Binkley. Looked it for a three, but didn't take it, and Calhoun will. And she's long, but Barlow tracks down the rebound. Nice pass inside there. Another good assist from Dunlap into Stricker for the left-handed layup. 10 points on the game here for Stricker. Good job there on two nice assists from Dunlap. Freshour takes a long two just inside the line and drains it. Dunlap's looking for them to move. Oh, Barlow with a nice roll. And unfortunately, Stricker didn't see her. Dunlap takes it in for two. Beautiful roll there on that play by Barlow. And that ball is tapped by Calhoun, but it goes over to Freshour. And they got it. You're trapped in the corner. And Coach Brooke is going to call a timeout on the floor with 4:12 left to go in the third period. Argos is up 47-15 over the Pioneer Lady Panthers. CNS Outdoor Power Equipment owners Richie and Amy Miller, located on North Michigan Street in Argos. Phone number is 574-892-5790. Hours of operation Tuesday through Saturday, 8:30 to 5. Full service and sales. They sell Toro Kohler steel mowers and trimmers, chainsaws, snow blowers, and much, much more. They also service what they sell, as well as sharpened chainsaws, lawnmower repairs. They do on-site service calls. Pickup and delivery is also available. Give Richie and Amy a call today at 574-892-5790. Freshour triggers the ball in to Landis. Landis, nice little drive, but she gets blocked by Barlow. Dunlap gets it to Barlow at the top of the free throw line, and a little weave, and Dunlap just goes right in for a nice little layup. That makes it 49-15. Almost picked off by Binkley. Basically. Fresh Hour gets it over to Landis. Landis misses the shot, but it's rebounded by Pioneer, and Landis gets her shot blocked, and Stricker gets the rebound. Dunlap gets it over to Calhoun. Back up to Dunlap. Dunlap has it at the top of the key. Gets it over to Binkley. Calhoun over to Dunlap. Oh, nice cut by Binkley. Stricker for three. Off the mark, but Barlow gets the rebound and gets it back out. Calhoun's got it. And Freshhour went down hard, but she looks like she's all right. Landis for three. I'm not sure what happened there. Okay, we got a foul on Barlow. Her second. Team second. We got some subs in. Barlow, Stricker, and Calhoun are going to go out. And Kuntz and Dunlap and Bailey Nifong come in. And that's Morgan Dunlap. And there's a turnover for Pioneer.
The lineup for the Panthers, number 40, Madison Kaufman.
Kaufman comes back in and Parsley goes out. Anna Parsley. Dunlap brings it across for the Lady Dragons. 2:32 left to go in the third period. 49-15 is the score. Nice look in and easy layup for Binkley. Got some nice work here by Courtney Dunlap this evening. She's got a ton of points and as well four or five really nice assists. And there's a turnover for Pioneer and Binkley gets a hold of it. No shot. They're going to call the foul on the floor. I think they're going to get Cassidy Morris, number 23. That is her first and first of the half and quarter for Pioneer. Almost turned over. Oh, Morgan Dunlap cannot get it over Kaufman. And they're coming back quickly, Landis. And she's going to be fouled by Nifong on the other end, and she's going to have two free throws here for the Pioneer. First free throw for Landis is off the front and rolls in. Got one more coming up. And it's off the front and rolls in as well. And Macy Stricker is going to check back in for the Lady Dragons. And Courtney Dunlap's going to go out. Coach Teal's going to move Morgan over to the point. And she's going to bring the ball across the timeline for the Lady Dragons. Nice pass from Nifong into Binkley, but she's unable to convert, and Freshhour brings it up for Pioneer. Morgan Dunlap is on Tia. And the rebound's knocked out of the hands of Stricker and into the hands of Kaufman, who puts it in for two. Minute 14 left to go in the third. Stricker has it on the right wing. Oh, Stricker looked for Binkley there, but it's picked off by McWhorter. First turnover of the half for the Lady Dragons. McWhorter can't hit the shot over Stricker, and rebound by Kuntz. Morgan brings it across the timeline. Stricker misses the 10-footer. And the rebound goes Pioneer, and Rachel Kuntz turns her head, and Landis goes right past her, And Rachel Kuntz never even knew she was there. That's what I say to you guys. You got to know where the ball is, right, McKenna? 16 seconds left to go in the third. 51-21. Seven seconds. At the buzzer, the three-pointer by Stricker's off the mark. And after three quarters of play, the score is 51-21. Argos with the lead. That was the closest quarter of the three for Pioneer. Had 19-6 in the first, 18-6 in the second, and 14-9 was the scoring for the third quarter. So after three quarters of play, the Lady Dragons are up 30 over Pioneer. And I'd like to thank C&S Automotive, owners Richie and Amy Miller, 574-892-9100, located North Michigan Street in Argos. Full service auto repair for all makes and models. They do oil changes, AC service, tune-ups, diagnostic services, tire repairs, and tire sales. And they also do much, much more, anything you need done for your vehicle. They can do it. So fourth quarter action, getting ready to go here from Pioneer. Courtney Dunlap back in, Macy Stricker, Anna Barlow, Morgan Dunlap, and Emily Calhoun for the Lady Dragons. So four of the five starters with Morgan Dunlap in for Kennedy Binkley. Freshhauer works on Dunlap, Morgan, and Morgan gets the block. Courtney looks ahead. She saw Stricker, but takes it in, and Barlow, they're going to call a tie-up, jump ball, so it will stay Argos ball on the alternating possession. Dunlap is going to inbounds for the Lady Dragons. Stricker for three. Way off the mark. Dunlap finds Stricker, tipped out of bounds, or saved from going out of bounds. Dunlap has it. Morgan Dunlap's going to take a three, and she sinks it.
Bucket by number 34, Morgan Dunlap.
Freshhauer brings it across, gets it over to Parsley. Freshhauer gets it stolen, and it goes ahead. Morgan Dunlap can't convert, and it's going to be controlled by Parsley. Nice athletic play there by Emily Brooke to catch that pass. And there's a travel on Morgan Dunlap. Two turnovers in the half, one for each team, or in the quarter, I mean. 6 minutes left to go. 54-21 is your score. Freshhauer gets it over to Parsley. Parsley back over to Freshhauer. Foot was on the line. And Stricker corrals the rebound. Stricker gets it up to Morgan Dunlap. Morgan passes into her sister for a nice little five-footer. And the bucket is good, makes it 56-21. tipped by Calhoun, but saved by Parsley. Morgan Dunlap, and it's stolen by Courtney. Courtney's going to go in strong all the way to the bucket and score on Madeline Parsley. Makes it 58-21. Parsley long on the three, rebounded by Dunlap. Dunlap gets it in to Stricker. Misses the shot, but the rebound by Barlow. Makes it 60-21 with 4.5 minutes left to go. And Freshour is going to go to the line, shooting two. Foul, I think, on Morgan Dunlap. We got some subs coming in.
As an Argos number 34, Morgan Dunlap, her first, team number four.
Freshour, first shot is good. Barlow, Stricker, and Calhoun are going to come out for Argos. And Nifong, Kuntz, and Binkley come in for the Lady Dragons. Dunlap. Pass is picked off by McWhorter. McWhorter takes a 15-footer, doesn't hit anything, and goes out of bounds. It's going to be Argos ball with 3:54 left to go in the game. Nice drive there by Morgan Dunlap to the basket, and she gets fouled by Madison Kaufman, and she's going to go to the line shooting two.
Number 40, Madison Kaufman, her third, team number two.
Well, they're saying that's her third, and they marked down three at the half, but anyway, Morgan puts the free throw in. Another one coming up here for Dunlap. And that one's off the mark, but Courtney tracks down her sister's miss. Passes over to Kuntz, who puts it in for two. Nice assist there from Courtney Dunlap to Rachel Kuntz for two. And the three-pointer from Landis is no good. Parsley, Madeline Parsley, not Landis, 15. And there is a turnover. Second of the quarter for Pioneer. Got 3:19 left to go in the game. Courtney Dunlap brings it across the timeline. Nice move there by Nifong, and a beautiful pass, and Morgan Dunlap drives it all the way to the bucket for two. Freshour drives baseline, and it's on the line. Morgan Dunlap tried to tiptoe the baseline and couldn't get it done. Cassidy Morris comes back in for Madeline Parsley. Kaufman has it. Looks for Freshour, and it's picked off by Morgan Dunlap. Morgan Dunlap gets it into Binkley, and she's short. Shoots it short, and rebound Kaufman. Nice drive there by McWhorter. And we got four new Lady Dragons getting ready to check into the game with 2:11 left to go in the game. Dunlap gets blocked by Kaufman. Fresh Hour has it, drives baseline on Binkley. And Binkley, I think, got a little piece of that. And Morgan gets the rebound, gets it to Courtney, gets it up to Nifong, and Rachel Kuntz takes a long three and comes up a little short. Kennedy Binkley saves it, but it goes into the hands of Fresh Hour. And Fresh Hour is going to be fouled by Courtney Dunlap. That'll be her second, I believe, and the team's fifth. Ashley Dean, Abby Manikowski, Sam Stone, and Macy Morris are checking in. And they're going to leave Morgan Dunlap. So Bailey Nifong, Kennedy Binkley, Rachel Kuntz, and Courtney Dunlap are going to go out for the Lady Dragons. With a minute 41 left to go, it's a 65-25 ball game. And Fresh Hour brings it across, passes it over to Deanna Johnson, who gets it to Cassidy Morris, over to Fresh Hour. Fresh Hour drives, kicks it back out. Back over to Tia. Up top now with Deanna Johnson. And Morris's pass is picked off by Dunlap. Manikowski's pass is stolen. And Dunlap picks Tia's pocket and is going to go all the way. Doesn't put it in. Gets the rebound. Kicks it back out to Stone, who takes a three and is off the mark. But a rebound. Dunlap, no foul call. Ashley Dean has it. Passes a nice pass to Macy Morris, who puts it in for two. With 27 seconds left, 67-25. Three-pointer is good for Fresh Hour. And 2-1, and that's the ball game. Final score from Pioneer, 67, Argos Lady Dragons, and the Pioneer Lady Panthers, 28. The Lady Dragons will move to 8-0 on the year, and Pioneer will fall to 2-6. I want to thank all of our sponsors here for the broadcast this evening for bringing you Argos Lady Dragon basketball on RTC4.com. Thank you for tuning in. We're going to check out here from Pioneer High School. We'll get some stats and stuff. We're going to be back on the air on Friday night, going to be back at Phil Wainwright Gymnasium for the first time in four games. Had four road games for the Lady Dragons, but it was a good trip. They come out in undefeated, and they're going to be taking on the Lady Eagles from the Culver Girls Academy. So we'll get to see the closest neighboring school to Argos, Culver Girls Academy, on Friday night, and then they'll be at home on Saturday night as well versus the New Prairie Lady Cougars, a new addition to the schedule. So for Alex Stearns and the silent one, McKenna Stricker, Steve Stricker, and good night here from Pioneer, where the Lady Dragons have won 67-28 over the Pioneer Lady Panthers.